Hello everyone, welcome to this class. We are discussing about equivalent circuit of a transformer. A transformer has got two parts, the primary and the secondary. The primary has the resistance and the reactance. The secondary has the reactance and the resistance. So in such a case, for calculation purposes, we do push the resistance and the reactance to the primary, or you can push the primary resistance and the primary reactance to the secondary. So we will be looking at equivalent circuit referred to primary. When you talk about equivalent circuits referred to primary, it means you are pushing the resistance in the secondary, reactance in the secondary to the primary. It's called equivalent circuit referred to primary. The secondary resistance and the secondary reactance are pushed to the primary. And for you to push the resistance in the secondary to the primary, you have to push it in such a manner that the power it would cause when it is the power loss it would cause when it is in the secondary is equal to the power loss it would cause when it's pushed to the primary. That is why we will say the power loss it would cause when it is in the secondary is given as I2 squared multiplied by the resistance R2 should be equal to the power loss it would cause when it is pushed to the primary. Remember, in the primary, the current flowing there is I1, so it's I1 squared multiplied by the resistance when it is pushed to the primary. When the resistance R2 is pushed to the primary, we put a prime, meaning we will take the current in the primary squared multiplied by the resistance we have actually pushed to the primary. From this particular point, you will see that R2 prime will be equal to I2 squared I1 squared multiplied by R2. I've divided both sides by I1. Remember, this is the same as I2 over I1 squared R2. Remember, this one can also be written as in terms of voltage. If you write current in terms of voltages, if you write currents in terms of the voltages, remember we have said before that I2 over I1 is the same as N1 over N2 is the same as V1 over V2. So if you write the current in terms of the voltages or the reactance or the number of turns, then in this case we'll be having V1 over V2 squared R2. You can go ahead and write it in terms of the number of turns. There is no problem. So we have found out that this is what you will be able to get. The same case applies when you are transferring the reactance. If you push the reactance, remember we have said, so one thing you need to note about this, if you push resistance from the secondary to the primary, then you will start with V1 over V2 squared times the number times the resistance R2. We are starting with V1 because we are taking the primary. We are referring to the primary. If you refer to the secondary, then you will have to start with V2. The same case applies if you are using the number of turns. So meaning, if you are using the reactance, if you talk about the total resistance, once you push the secondary reactor, the secondary resistance to the primary, this resistance will come to join with R1. So the total resistance, when you add R1 plus the resistance you have brought in, the total resistance is called the R equivalent, the equivalent resistance. This equivalent resistance is given by R1, which was initially the primary, plus R2 prime that you have brought in. And remember, R2 prime is given by this formula. So it can be the same as R1 plus R2 prime, V1 over V2 squared R2. You can write it in that form. Remember, in this case, you can write N1 over N2. There is no problem. That is how you get the total resistance. Number two, you can talk of reactance. You can have the reactance there. If you push R2 to this point, you will be having R2 prime, which will be equal to, I can use N1, N2 squared X2. Remember, I've said because we are pushing X2 to the primary, we start with the primary parameters. We start with the primary parameters. N1 over N2 squared divided by this. And I think I've illustrated where the square is coming from. So that is how you get it. That is how you will be able to get this one. The same case applies. If you want to get the total reactance, the total reactance XE, this E implies the equivalent reactance, will be equal to X1 plus X2 prime. This will be the same as, X1 plus N1 N2 squared X2. So we are using the number of times ratio of the voltage to push X2 to the primary. So the equivalent circuit will appear like this. The equivalent circuit then will appear like this. Before we look at the equivalent circuit, remember we have said you can be able to draw a triangle, a phasor diagram to represent this. Remember, the resistance is drawn on the horizontal scale, meaning our RE will be drawn on the horizontal axis. Then our equivalent reactance will be drawn on the vertical scale. And our impedance, Z, will be drawn on the hypotenuse. Then the angle that is formed here is called the phase angle. So how do you get the phase angle? The phase angle, phi will be equal to tan inverse will be given inverse of, remember, tan is given the opposite of adjacent. So meaning XE all over RE. That is how you get the phase angle phi. I'm saying that because you know phi, you know tan phi will be equal to XE all over RE. So if you take if you want to get phi, you get tan inverse of that. So that is how you'll be able to get this. That is how to get the angle. The next thing that you can be asked to get is the impedance. Impedance Z. How do you get the impedance Z? Impedance Z is equal to RE squared plus XE squared under root. Remember, we are using Pythagoras theorem, because we have in the triangle, Z is given by this particular formula. Now we can look at the equivalent circuit. Equivalent circuit will be drawn like this. Remember, in this case, we'll be talking about RE. Remember, we have said RE is the same as R1 plus R2 prime. We will also be talking about equivalent reactance. This is the same as X1 plus X2, referred to the primary. Then we take that. This is I2. This is I1. And we can talk about this our V2 on the other side. V2 on the other side. So this one is called equivalent circuit referred to the primary. We have pushed the secondary parameters to the primary. That is why we are calling it, equivalent circuit referred to the primary. Equivalent circuit referred to the primary. So we are going to apply all these that we have learnt in an example so that we can be able to finish up. We look at an example. The example reads, a transformer has 600 turns in the primary and 150 in the secondary. The primary resistances are given as 0.25. This is given as 0.01. Reactances are given as, and the corresponding leakage reactances is 1 and 0.4. This is 1. This is 0.04. Those are the parameters we have been given. Remember, like we said, you need to push. You need to simplify this circuit so that you can be able to get the parameters easily. So we are going to push the primary, the secondary parameters to the primary. So the first thing you will do, remember we have been told to get the equivalent impedance referred to the primary. So the first thing you will do, you have to get R2 referred to the primary. You are pushing R2 to the primary. Remember we have said in this equation again, we have been given 600 to 150. This is N1 and this is N2. So remember we have said R2 referred to the primary is given by N1 divided by N2 squared multiplied by R2. This will be equal to the number of turns there is 600 all over 150 squared multiplied by R2, which is a 0.04. So if you use your calculator, then you will get, you will get 600 divided by 150 squared times 0.04, that is 600 divided by 150 squared times 0.01, sorry, the resistance here is 0.01, this is our 0.01. You will get it as 0.16 ohms. That is the R2 referred to the primary. Remember we said the equivalent resistance will be equal to R1 plus R2 prime. This will be the same as, what is our R1? Our R1 is 0.25 plus the referred resistance is 0.1. If you add 0.25, you will get it as 0.41 ohms. So that is the total resistance in the circuit. We look at the the reactance. The reactance referred to the primary. Reactance referred to the primary, X2 prime, will be equal to N1, N2 squared, multiplied by X2. This will be equal to, what is our N1? Our N1 is 600, all over 150, squared, multiplied by 0.04. If you do your math, divided by 150 squared, you get that times 0.04. You will get it as 0.64 ohms. You get it as 0.04 ohms. And then remember, for you to get the total resistance, the total reactance, the equivalent reactance is equal to x1 plus x2 prime. This will be equal to our x1 is 1 ohm. Remember, this was 1.0. So that is 1.0 plus 0.64. This is the same as 1.64 ohms. That is 1.64 ohms. So we have been able to get all these parameters. These are the parameters that we have been able to get. Remember, our question requires us to get the equivalent impedance. The equivalent impedance. So what we will do, we will draw the equivalent circuit. We are going to draw the equivalent circuit for this particular case. Remember, the equivalent circuit will now be the same as this is our I2 and this is our V2. This is our I1. And remember, we have said this is our RE. Our RE in this case is our RE is 0.41. And this is our XE, which is the same as 1.64 ohms. And remember, our voltage still remains to be, we have not been given the voltage in that case. So these are the parameters that we have. We can now be able to answer the question. The question we are given, the question we are given is, we are supposed to get the impedance. Remember, you can draw the phasor diagram. Like I said, this is our RE, which is equal to, our RE, which is 1.64. We have our XE, which is equal to 1.64. Remember, this is a right angle triangle. This is our phi. That is our impedance. Remember, Z squared is equal to X squared plus R squared according to Pythagoras' theorem. So meaning our Z will be equal to the square root of X squared plus that squared. So if you want to get the impedance will be the same as 0.41 squared plus 1.64 squared under root. If you use your calculator, squared plus 0.41 squared, then you get the root. Then you get the root. You'll be able to get 1.69. So Z will be equal to 1.69 ohms. That is your impedance. If you want to get this angle, the phase angle, remember that was our question one. If you want to get question B requires us to get the phase angle. The phase angle, tan phi, the phase angle is given by this, is equal to opposite of adjacent, which is XE all over RE. This is the same as 1.64 divided by, sorry, there was a mistake that we made here. Remember, our RE is 0.41. So divided by 0.41, So if you want to get phi, phi is the same as, you take tan inverse. Remember, if you divide it there, you will get 1.64 divided by 0.41.